And I think that today God heals, but he doesn't give that gift today to man. But Paul had that gift, and he not only had the gift of healing, he could raise the dead, and that was the mark of an apostle. Peter raised the dead. Paul raised the dead, you see. Now, Paul is a bond slave of Jesus Christ. He's a called apostle. And now, the third thing that is said here, he's separated under the gospel of God. And I want you to notice this, because this is a remarkable thing. He was separated unto, and not separated from something, but separated unto the gospel of God. And it's God's gospel because he originated. The gospel, you see, is something God thought of. I didn't think of it. Man didn't think of it. The Lord didn't say 1,900 years ago, well, I know it's the fullness of time, and it's time for Jesus to come into the world, but maybe Vernon McGee won't like it. Maybe he's got a better program, and we'll wait till he gets here. He didn't do that at all. I got here, and the gospel had been in existence 1,900 years, and it's God's gospel. And he said that to me, he says, you take it or leave it. And by the way, he's saying that to you. You take it or leave it. He originated the gospel. But Paul says he's separated unto the gospel. Not separated from something, but separated unto. And this is a very marvelous word, by the way. Separated unto. And there are several words that almost have an opposite meaning. For instance, you take the word cleave. A thing can cleave to something, or you can cleave a thing asunder. It actually can mean one time to join together, and another time it can mean to separate. Now, the word separated. We hear so much today about this matter of separation. Well, Paul was a separated Christian, but he is separated to something, not from something. And I'm afraid that we've got a great many Christians that are separated from something. In fact, when I hear some talk, I have an idea they're doing a spiritual striptease. They say, I've taken this off, I don't do this, I don't do that. Well, my friend, what are you separated unto? Not what you're separated from. And the important thing is to be separated unto something. Now, Paul said about the Thessalonians, how they turned to God from idols. They didn't get up in a testimony meeting and say, oh, I don't go to the temple of Apollo anymore. They didn't need to say that. They were separated unto the Lord Jesus. And when they're separated unto him, why, you don't need to be separated from something. I hear people today say, should a Christian be separated from something? And they mention something. And I think there's so many barren lives, they get separated from something, and they're joyless, and they become very critical, and some even very cynical. My friend, you're to be separated unto Christ. Now, when you're separated unto Christ, then the separation from takes place. A man gets married. I have in my marriage ceremony, do you promise to love and to keep yourself under her or under him and no one else? And that's separation, separated under one person. That's what marriage is. Well, imagine a fella getting married, and the first night of his honeymoon, he says to his new bride, he says, I got a girlfriend in this town. I think I'll call her up and go over to see her. And there are a lot of Christians that's the kind of separation they have, you see. It's a separation from something, but not under something. And if you're separated unto the Lord Jesus, then, my friend, you're not going to worry about this separated from something. And the very interesting thing is it means that you've got a life that appeals, not one that turns people off. A lot of people turn the unsaved off by their lives. There was a little Chinese girl once said, you know, says Christians are salt. Salt makes you thirsty. That's the one to think over, friend. And by the way, are you and I making anybody thirsty for Christ? He's the water of life. Do we make them thirsty? And by the way, this word separated is a very interesting word. In my notes, I talk about this word, for it occurs again a little later on. But it's the same word we get our word horizon from. And it's aphorizo, and it means it would be off or from horizon. I always, in taking a plane trip, have noticed something that when the plane takes off, it brings you up to places where the horizon gets enlarged. I remember that taking off in Athens. And when we took off, my, you couldn't see anything. I tried to see the Acropolis. I tried to see the ocean. I couldn't see a thing. We hadn't gone very far. You could see the ocean. You could see the Acropolis. You could see the islands. You could see the mountains. You could see it all when you get up there. The higher we went, why, the wider the horizon got. And how wonderful it is to be separated unto Christ, because he brings you to the place where your horizons are enlarged and you're given a new life in Christ Jesus. And how wonderful that new life is. It brings you to a new place and appreciation of life. This is what I mean. Paul said, when I was a child, I spoke as a child, I acted as a child. When I came a man, I put away childish things. Now, there was a time when I can recall as a boy that I used to play house because there were a bunch of girls in the neighborhood, and there were only a couple of us boys, and so in order to play, we played house. Well, there came a day, friends, when I outgrew that stuff, and I went out and played baseball. And the girls would say, let's play house. And I said, no, I'm playing first base on the team. I'm not interested in that. A new horizon. And then there came a day when I not only not interested in playing baseball, I can't play baseball. But the thing is that I'm interested in something else. Horizons have widened out. And if you come to Christ, you're separated unto him. Separation doesn't mean you're drawn in and you become little and narrow. Why, it means, friends, that your life has broadened out. And today there's so many wonderful things that you can do as a child of God. And you can have an appreciation of things today. May I say to you that it's thrilling to live today. What a glorious, wonderful thing it is. Now, he says here, he's separated under the gospel of God. And this is a wonderful verse.